Hello, we meet again and welcome back to my channel. So today's video will be explaining of how to make the AVR running LED codes. As you might have seen in my channel, I've shared or I published some videos of running LED. There are actually four types of running LED. There are the 8 channel running LED, the 12 channels, the 16 channels and the 22 channel. The LED love, which is very cool and so fun to watch. So if you are interested and if you want to create one of those running LED, so here I'm going to show you or to share you how to create the codes. So the AVR needs some program to work. You need to operate this LED using control or using command from the hex code. Okay, so you're gonna have to write it by yourself. In order to make those code, you need some programs. First, you need to a software to simulate the code to check whether if your code is working or not. And then you're gonna need the programming language. Well, there are few programming language that you could use, such as Atmel Studio, and then CodeFusion and Bascom AVR, which is the simplest. So here I'm going to show you how to create maybe the simplest way to create a code using the Bascom AVR. I assume that you have installed the Bascom AVR. I'm gonna start from the beginning, from the scratch, so you can see how to create a schematic first and then how to choose the programming language. So I'm gonna start from the new one, creating a new project. Okay, let's start. Choose a folder first. Next, I'm gonna choose the dock because to save my eyes from itching. Okay, here is one of the most important thing. You are going to need the Creative Firmware project. Choose the AVR, choose Atmega 8. I choose this Atmega 8 because this is the smallest and the cheapest, but you could use a lot of things using this small chips. And I'm going to choose Bascom AVR here. And if you're just finished installing Bascom AVR, you might see that there is a node like this not configured, so you're gonna have to configure it. Here's how. Choose the Bascom AVR and then click checks, but because I've configured it, so I'm gonna skip it. Okay, and click next. Oopsie, the code's still empty. First, you're going to need to change the PCB package, which is I'm using the SPDL28. Okay. And then you're going to need to add components needed here, the electronical components, which is I actually already added it, but if you're first time using it, you can add resistor, for example. Double click on it, set it here, and add all electronical components that you need. I'm using the port B of the Atmega 8. I'm add 8 LEDs here, and then you can connect the output line of VVO to here, and then here, and connect all this line to this LED pin. So I think I'm going to skip this step. So this is the final schematic looks like, or the finished schematic, which is pretty simple. And you need to know that in Atmega 8 there are 3 ports here. There are the B port, D port and the C port, and I'm going to use only port B here as the output, but you could actually use all of this output. But in order to make it easier to understand, I'm going to use only one port. So you have to connect all of this pin to the LED, pin B0, pin B1 and until pin B7. There are 8 pins, and connect all to those LEDs. So now we are going to create the code. So this is the empty code. We're not using the code here yet. We'll see how it works. Nothing happened. Nothing happened because there is no command, or there is no control from the code to activate or to control the running LED. So the easier way. So the easier way will be go to my site and see the example code. You can see the link from the description. Go to the middle of the content and copy the code. Replace this code with the newly copied code, and then let's see what happens. You see, the code is working fine and the animation is running well now. And now I'm going to show you, or to explain you, how this works. First, you need to define this two line direct file m8devdev, because we are using the Atmega 8, so this is the definition. And then the crystal. The crystal here means the clock frequency, of the clock speed of this Atmega 8. We are using the internal clock, so we don't have to use another crystal. So we could use the built-in crystal here. See? Yes, this is the 1 megahertz crystal, means 1 million hertz. So, and then the next, the configuration, we are using the port B as the output. As I said earlier, we are using only the output, so the output of this code will be working only for the port B. Only this pin will work and the rest will not, because we do not configure it. Next will be to define how the animation works. So I have made the lampu as a light for port B. Lampu means light or LED, and I declare it again here. And then this sequence of number, the 1 sequence of number, the 1 is representing the state of on. That means the LED will be turned on. Otherwise, this 0 sequence number is representing the off state of the LED. Means it will be turned off. Okay, so next will be the wait ms here. The wait ms means wait in millisecond. This means duration of how the animation goes, or how long the animation goes. If you change this value to 10 times bigger, let's see what happens. see, the duration is 10 times longer. Next code will be here. So this is the function for repetition. Means if you want to make the animation last for 3 times, you can type 3 here. Or if you want to make it longer, 5 times for example, so the animation will repeat 5 times. Let's see. Five. Yes, it is. It is 5 times. The rest will be to play with the on or off state, so you can make a good variation or you can make a good animation. All depend on how you play the state to choose which LED are on or which LEDs are off. So for easier example or easier reading, let's slow it down. Okay. Let's try another animation. We can copy to new line here. I want the first 2 LED on and the rest off. Simple as that. So you could play with your own imagination, or you can make a good animation and create a good movement or good running LED. All will be depend on how creative you are. So play with it. Another code. I think you can imagine how this code will be or how this animation will be. Gerak keluar means move out, means all first LED will be off and then the 2 LED turn it on from the center. It goes wider, 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 and then it goes back to narrow to the center, so on and so forth. So just simply play with the code and use your imagination. Next, when you finish your code, or if you want to make this code to be applied in a real component, or you want to flash it, to flash this code into your Atmega 8 chip, all you can do is first get the hex code. You can get the hex code from here. See, this is the debug.hex here. This is the hex code to be flashed later, to the flash to your chip. So copy this file, place it somewhere here for example, and then run your AVR burner. Of course, first plug your USB ASP burner and then open the code. Yep, the code will be like this, and then select your Atmega chip and write it all. If you want to add more channel or more LED, for example 16 LED, you can use the other port D and add more 8 more LED and connect to each pin, so on and so forth, and then you can add new configuration. For example, port B, and make a different light, and then here so on and so forth. All will depend on your creativity. Just play with it. So that will be all. I hope you like this video. Thank you for watching and see you.